A host of organizations made sure that every American was doing his or her patriotic duty. The American Protective League boasted 250,000 members across the country. The Justice Department gave the APL semi-official status by supplying it with armbands and badges. League men embarked on illegal searches and seizures, detained and arrested men without charges, intimidated allegedly disloyal Americans, and broke up strikes. In the fall of 1918, they unleashed a series of so-called slacker raids in cities across the country.
They organized slacker raids with the idea of rounding up men who are evading the draft. They fan out across these cities. They go into Nickelodeons, they go into movie theaters. They wait at the exits of fairs to catch people when they're walking home, onto city buses, beaches, pulling in any guy that's not carrying his draft card. These vigilante groups are wandering around just assaulting civilians.
One September morning, 20,000 agents surrounded the entrances to every subway, train, and ferry station in New York, then launched hundreds of raids across the city. Over 3 days, almost 500,000 men were interrogated and 60,000 detained. It was the largest police action in the country's history. The New York raid netted just 199 draft dodgers. Yet President Wilson was satisfied, commenting that the raids would put the fear of God into any potential shirkers.